Hello students, you must have heard your parents and grandparents discussing and criticizing the policies of the government. You might be wondered that what is government, where does it work, what it works. So let me try to give the answer of these questions. Made by joining two Latin words, governare means to direct or to govern and mente means minding. Government is act of governing or ruling the minds of the people. In simple term, the group of people who have the authority to govern an area, to supervise or to administer an area and take decisions for a country or a state is government. Now, it arises that how it supervises or governs an area. So the answer is in levels of the government. Government works at different level. Central level, it is the topmost level of the government. The central government looks after the national interest like defense, finance and foreign affairs. The prime minister is the head of the central government. State level, different states have their own government. The state government is headed by the chief minister. It looks after the state subjects like roads, education, agriculture. Local self-government operates at the lowest level. It works at grassroots level, very close to the people, as in rural area, that means the area of villages, and urban, that is the area of the cities. Government is powered to make decisions and enforces the law. The answer to this question is in different types of government: democracy, rule of many; monarchy and dictatorship, in which only one person rule; oligarchy, in which few persons rule; and anarchy, in which no one rules. One of the common form of the government, which is derived from the word monarch, means king. Monarchy is the form of government headed by king or queen. The king enjoys supreme power. The position of the king or queen is hereditary. It means that the child of the king or queen inherits its property or inherit its trait. King or queen do not have to explain their actions or defend the decisions they take. In this system, people have no say in selection of the government. Monarchy is still being practiced in a handful of countries like Bhutan and Saudi Arabia. Most of the monarchies today are constitutional, means the power of the king are limited by the democratic government. Democracy is made up of two Greek words, demos and kratos, which means rule of the people. Democracy is defined as the government by the people, for the people and of the people. It is of two types, direct and representational. In direct democracy, the people come together to influence the policies by direct voting. It is in Switzerland. Representational is indirect form of democracy in which the people rule indirectly with the help of their representatives. In the modern context, most of the countries follow representational democracy. In this system, people elect their representative through popular elections and a government is formed on the basis of people's choice. In India, after every 5 years, elections are held. Democracy in India. India is considered as the largest democratic country. This is achieved as the result of long and eventful struggle. In India, before independence, only a small minority enjoyed the voting right. This was shocking for Gandhiji. He firmly disapproved this system, expressing his idea in the journal Young India, which was written in 1931. Gandhiji said that it is discriminating to deprive poor and illiterate people of voting right. He demanded that all adults should have the right to vote. This system is known as universal adult franchise. It means that all adult citizen of the country have the right to vote without any discrimination. This process is based on the concept of equality. This means that every adult citizen, an adult is a person who has attained the age of 18 or above, irrespective of his or her caste, color, economic status, has right to vote. In most of the countries, the poor and the women had to fight for participation in government. Women's struggle to vote got strengthened during First World War. This movement is called the Women's Suffrage Movement. During the World War I, many men were away fighting, and because of this, women were called to organize and to manage the different kinds of work. So, women began to be seen as being equally capable of making decisions. So, the suffragette movements demanded the right to vote for all the women. American women got the right to vote in 1921, and the women of UK got the right to vote in 1928. Now let's talk about the functions of the government. Government is needed to make decisions and to get things done. Government takes decision on various matters like how and where to build roads, schools and railway lines, how to improve the public healthcare system, how to improve the supply of drinking water and many more. The government is required to protect the boundaries of the country. It also needs to maintain cordial relations with other countries. The government has to ensure that all the citizens get enough to eat. In case of a natural disaster, the government carries out relief operation to help affected people. The government also needs to maintain the rules and regulations so that everyone can live in harmony. So let us talk about the government. Government makes the laws, and everyone who lives in the country has to follow these. The government has the power to make decisions and enforce it. If someone feels that a particular law is not being obeyed, he can go to the court with his or her grievances, means his or her problems. The court needs to hear the case and announce decisions as per the law. And it is not all over. After the decisions of the court, the government officials need to ensure that law is properly enforced. It might be clear to all that the life without government would be very difficult. So, thank you.